Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I'm going to go through a little design challenge that I sort of made for myself. Over the weekend, we saw this chart, this weather forecast chart, posted on the news on TV, and I saw that the scale was off, the temperature labels were off, and I wondered if I could remake this chart with data from weather.com. And I wondered if I could remake it in PowerPoint. And turns out I could. So I wanted to walk you through the process that I used to make this chart. A few of the things that I noticed when I started kind of looking at this chart and thinking about making it in PowerPoint is I first see this background. It's kind of a blue gradient background, so I know that I can make my slide sort of this blue gradient, and I'll show you how to do that. And then I notice the chart is really kind of like this line chart right here, but it's also an area chart because you can see the area underneath the chart is lighter blue than the top blue. So we're going to have to do a few little workarounds to get that done. And then this chart has grid lines, these light blue grid lines here. I'm not sure that I really like those, so I think I'm going to make this chart without those grid lines. But the other one is these custom line markers along the chart, the weather icons. And, you know, we could probably just insert some icons or insert some shapes over the chart, but I think we can also embed these into the chart. So I'll show you how to do that as I walk through the slide. So let's go ahead and just minimize this picture just a little bit. We'll keep it off to the side just so that we can have a good little visual here for us. The first thing I'm going to do is we're going to change the chart. We're going to change the slide background. And this is just PowerPoint, Microsoft 365 that I'm working in. We're going to go ahead and click on Format Background, and then let's go ahead and make this a gradient already. I'm actually going to get rid of a few of the gradient stops, and then I see like up here in the corner it's a little lighter blue than this darker blue. So let's go ahead over to my direction, and we're going to make sure that we have that corner up there and the other color down here in the right corner. So let's go ahead and change this fill color. We're going to click on the eyedropper, and we're going to take the color right from the photo, and that changes that for us. And then this other lighter blue will also take the eyedropper and go all the way up here to the corner. That looks really nice. That doesn't look too much different, but I can see a very slight difference. If I wanted to make this a little lighter, I could actually go in and customize the color and more color and just kind of change the slider a little bit to make it a tiny bit lighter. Nice. And now it looks like it's going that way. Actually, it looks like maybe I have to swap because it looks like the darker part is up here. So let me see if I can change how this is noted on that direction. It looks pretty good, I think. There we go. Maybe that's a little bit better. Okay, that's perfect. Then let's just go ahead and make the title of the chart. So I'm just gonna, right here, insert a rectangle. And we're just gonna do that right over the border here. We're gonna make the rectangle white with no line. And we'll just type right into the shape. Denver forecast. Now the text is white, so we're just going to go ahead and update that text. We'll do that same blue. Denver forecast. Let's go ahead and set it to all uppercase. We'll bold it, and then we'll increase the size quite a bit. All right, perfect. Now let's go ahead and insert the chart. And to do that, all we need to do is go up to the Insert tab, and then we're gonna go ahead and insert that chart. I'm gonna insert an area chart right now. It's gonna give us a series of data with just kind of this default area chart, and it's gonna give us two series of data. What I'm gonna do is I've already typed in my temperature data on a different spreadsheet here. I'm gonna go and copy it. What I'm gonna do here is paste it in. And you can see that the formatting is a little bit off there. That's still set to date, so I really want this to be formatted as text. So what we're going to go ahead and do is change the formatting of the cells to text. And that's just going to be 5 p.m. And this is going to be 7 p.m. Looks like I really needed to change everything here. Looks like it didn't quite work as I wanted it to, really. So I'll just retype these in. 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 1 p.m., 3 p.m. All right, that's good. And now I have my temperature series over here. Now I still have this extra series that the dummy area chart gave me, so I'm actually just going to go ahead and copy this. So let's actually copy this, and then we're going to paste it in. So we have two series of data. One of them is going to be our line, and one of them is going to be our area. So for now, let's go ahead and close the source data. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of some of these elements on the chart that we don't need. The legend, get rid of the legend. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the tick marks on that axis line. Perfect. And let's get rid of these grid lines. And I'm going to go ahead and just format the chart a little bit right here so that we can see it, but keep that picture there. Let's make the text on the axis white and bold. And we don't need our y-axis there, but I'm going to keep it there just for now. All right, so now let's go ahead and make this. Let's go ahead and change this so that we have the yellow line and the area underneath. So what we're going to do is right-click and change on chart type. And I'm going to go to combo. Now remember, we have two series of data here. They're both the same. The first series is going to be, I'm going to actually keep this as our area. And then the second series is going to be a line. So it's already set to line, but we want it to be line with markers. So I'm going to set it to that and then click OK. Now you can kind of get a sense of this is our line right here along the ridge, and then this is our area. And now let's figure out how to color the line so that it matches the color in the photo. So I'm going to click on this and go up to line, and then right now it's orange, but we'll select more colors, and we'll just go, oops, I'm going to actually select the paint, the eyedropper tool again, and we're just going to go over here to the yellow. Now we can make that nice and yellow, and now my markers, we actually don't need these right now, but I'm going to make them just a little bit bigger so that you can see them. We're going to update those to the custom icons in just a bit. Let's deal with the fill color of the area. I want it to be this gradient light to dark blue down to the bottom. So we're going to click on this, and then I'm going to make sure that the area is highlighted. We'll click on gradient. And I already have my gradient saved from the background of the slide, but it's not quite the same that's not quite the same direction that I want. So we want this to go from the top down. You can also look at these preset gradients. It's going to be linear, but I want it to be this. Let's see. I think we want it to be this one, the lighter on the top. Yeah, perfect. So now you can see this lighter blue on the top, and now I can work with the gradient stops to tell it how much I want it to go into the bottom, and I think that looks really nice. Now you can see that we have the edges here, which we're going to deal with. We'll deal with that in the chart itself. But let's see, what else do I want to do? It looks like the slope, the distribution, the shape of this curve isn't quite as large as this, so as large as the photo. So let's go ahead and adjust the axis just a little bit. We're going to say minimum of 60. And there, it already automatically changes to a maximum of 100. And it already sort of looks like the slope that we want it to look like. And I took the numbers from weather.com instead of this chart, which is clearly not accurate because 93 is not less than 92 all the way at the top. All right, let's go ahead and I'm going to move this off to the side. And let's drag our chart just a little bit more. That looks pretty nice. Now let's deal with the weather icons. So most of these are going to be partly sunny. And then we had a couple over here at 3 o'clock and 5 o'clock where there was like a chance of thunder and rain. So let's go ahead, I'm going to move this off, and let's go ahead and insert some icons that we're going to use for our shapes. So let's go ahead and insert. I'm going to go up to the icons tab here, and let's just type in partly sunny and see what we get. All right, well, I get a sun, so let's go ahead and get that sun in there. That looks nice. And let's go ahead and color it yellow because I know it's that same yellow. Let's go ahead and insert a cloud on top of that. Let's see. Oh, and there's a nice little lightning bolt. Oh, look, and there's a partly sunny, but I can't make them both two different colors if I insert the same image. So I want to have just a normal single cloud that I can kind of lay on top of my sun right here. And we're going to make that white. And we're going to make the line black. And I'll adjust the thickness just a little bit. Perfect. So I'm going to group these, Control G. I'm going to make one more. And let's find a raindrop. There's my nice raindrop. And let's go ahead and find what color this is. I'm going to go to the eyedropper tool. And all the way over here on the edge, I see that little raindrop. It's a really bright blue turquoise. I'm going to go ahead and make it like that, and we'll put it right over there. And I'm not going to do the lightning bolt, but if you wanted a lightning bolt, you could put it in there too. And I'm going to group this together. So Shift and then Control G to group. Perfect. All right. Now what we can do is we can fill our icons with our shapes. So go ahead and click the series of markers, go up to the marker tab. Under marker options, we will go here to the marker options. Right now it's at the built-in circle, but we're going to go ahead and say picture. And we haven't saved this picture yet, which is what I wanted to do. So we need to first save this as a picture. So right click and save the group as a picture. I'm going to say partly sunny. And this is going to be, I'm going to save this as rain. All right, now we can go back to the series of markers. Click on the marker, format marker options, and then under, let's see, from file, and we will find our image here, partly sunny. Awesome. Now look how that looks. It actually fills those markers with the images that we created. So these are custom line markers. Now I'm going to put those over to the side. But you can see there's still lines around them. So let's go ahead and make sure that the lines are no longer there. On the marker menu, down to border, we're going to say no border. And then I think we could probably make our markers just a little bit smaller if it was possible. Once we do this, we can actually make them smaller. It doesn't look like when you have a picture like this, you can make them smaller, but I'm going to stretch this a little bit, so I think it will look okay. I do want these to be custom, so I'm going to actually click on the partly sunny and rainy icon. I'm going to go ahead and copy this. I'm going to isolate this one image right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say from clipboard, because it's already on my clipboard. So I'm going to go ahead and paste that in there. So we'll isolate those and they stay on my clipboard. That's perfect. Saw that a little bit there. All right. So this is looking pretty good. Now, the other thing I noticed in my photo, let's bring this to the front, is that the lines stretch all the way off the screen. So 81 is there, and then they go off the screen. We're gonna fix that. We can fix that inside our chart, and then we're going to stretch the chart across the size of the slide. I also noticed that they have data labels, and we don't yet. So let's go ahead and first make data labels. We'll add data labels here, and then we're gonna set them to above. And we'll set them to white and bold and nice and big text. Looks pretty good. Now I think my icons probably are just a tiny bit too big. So what I want to see is if I can make this a little smaller. We're going to adjust that down. I'm going to copy this and we'll see what happens if I insert that icon inside the markers. Now it fills them still with the smaller. Ah, but you can see then, Huh, that's weird. Anyway, let's just click undo. We'll like them like this for now. I think that looks okay. If you wanted to fiddle with the sizing, I think you could do that. You just have to save the photo as a smaller size, and then they will save pretty much to the size that you need here. I'm going to increase that just a little bit. All right, so now to stretch the chart just a little bit. What we need to do is we need to actually add another series of data on either end. We need to add a data point here on the left and add a data point here on the right. And it's just gonna be a copy. It's gonna be 81 and 72 so that the line stretches off the screen. So let's go ahead and update the source data. We'll right click and select edit data. And then here, I'm just gonna add an 81 on the end. And at the top, I'm going to insert a 72. Perfect. And then we'll close. Now you can see this. Now I don't want a data marker here, so I'm just going to isolate this and select no marker. Same for this. Now you can see that we have this line stretching. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to stretch my chart all the way off the pasteboard. We'll actually get rid of that one too. And so it's right along the edge there. And we'll do the same thing. Let's pan back so you can kind of see that on the slide. Let's get rid of this single label there. And I'm just going to nudge the plot area a little bit so that it fills that whole area. Nice. Now, behind the scenes, this looks kind of like a mess, but if we were to put it in slideshow mode or save this out as an image, you can see the entire thing looks like a perfect, beautiful image. And that's pretty close to the chart that we saw over on 9 News, don't you think? So, pretty cool. I think we went through how to adjust the color of your background, of your slide background. We added shapes and edited text to sort of copy the header of the chart. And then we worked with some of the fill gradients inside the chart, inside the area chart we did, and then on the background, and then we made the line the same beautiful yellow, and then we put in custom icon markers from our icons, and we created custom icons by kind of grouping a few different icons together and then making those be our chart markers. So a pretty cool trick, and I think it looks pretty nice. This looks like a pretty nice chart that we remade right from scratch, right inside PowerPoint. You didn't need any fancy design software. So if you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and tap the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a new tutorial in data design, PowerPoint, or Excel. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you already have access to. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.